Today, I'm gonna show you the easiest and fastest way to color grade your videos cinematically in DaVinci Resolve 18. And it also works in the free version of Resolve. So it's completely free. I mean, what more do you want, right? Now, I know that cinematic color grading is kind of tricky because, you know, it all comes down to personal preference. But I do think that most of you will like what I'm gonna show you today because you can still tweak and adjust everything the way you like. Look at all these amazing colors. These examples took me less than 5 minutes to do, and it works with log footage and footage shot with a standard picture profile. So it'll work with whatever camera you have. This video is sponsored by Motion VFX. Now, I've been doing some research and it seems like there are two slightly different variations of this color grading technique or method. But the one that I prefer to use, the one that I'm gonna show you, has one big advantage over the other one. You'll see. And of course, I'm also gonna show you how to do it if you're not working with log footage. So if you're using a standard picture profile on your camera. But first, log. Okay, so we're in DaVinci Resolve 18. This is my video clip. Let's go to the color page. And of course, first thing we need to do is bring our flat, poopy looking log image into the Rec. 709 color space. Now, you could try to do it manually, but there's a much easier way, color space transform. So let's add 3 more nodes. You'll see later why. And then this node will be the color space transform node, the Rec. 709 node. And then here in the effects library, look for the color space transform and drag and drop it onto that node. And it's super simple now. Input color space, it was shot with my Sony a7S III in sgamma3.cine, and input gamma was slog3. So make sure that you set this to your camera's profile. Output color space and gamma use timeline. And that's because my project and timeline settings are already set to Rec. 709. You see here in the project settings, I'm using Rec. 709A because I'm working on Mac. If you're not on Mac, it should be Rec. 709 gamma 2.4. And output same, so use timeline. And I discovered the existence of Rec. 709A just recently, thanks to someone in the comments. So thank you so much for that, because now all my exported videos look exactly the same across all devices. Before, when I was still using Rec. 709 and Gamma 2.4, my exported videos looked fine once uploaded to YouTube, but when I opened one on my Mac in QuickTime, for example, it looked way too dark. And using Rec. 709A solved that problem. So if you're on a Mac, use Rec. 709A. Okay, and now the image looks pretty good, it's Rec. 709, but of course you can always do some more color corrections and adjustments before the color transform node. I think it looks a bit too bright now, so in this node, let's adjust the exposure. There. And in this node, I could adjust the white balance, for example. And you can make as many nodes as you want before the color space transform. Skin tones, saturation, contrast, whatever. And once you're done, you'll have a great Rec. 709 base and you can start color grading. Or apply a LUT. And yeah, I know some of you don't like LUTs, but these are not just any LUTs. The cool thing about DaVinci Resolve is that it has built-in film look LUTs, film emulation LUTs. And they look great, guys, they really do. So open the LUTs panel here and then film looks. We have the DCI P3 LUTs here, the first 6, but we need these, Rec. 709 LUTs. Now, the problem is, you'd think that because it says Rec. 709, these LUTs will look great when applied to our Rec. 709 image. Let's try it. Here, the last node, that's where I'll apply the LUT. There. And it looks horrible. It's way too dark, the blacks are crushed, and that's because these supposedly Rec. 709 LUTs aren't really standard Rec. 709 LUTs. They're designed for scanned film footage, and scanned film footage comes in the color space gamma Cineon film log. So how can we make these LUTs look good when applied to our 709 footage? Well, first let me show you how I used to do it. And it's not wrong to do it like this, but there's a better way. So in our color space transform node, all you need to do is set the output gamma to Cineon film log. And boom, it instantly looks a lot better. And when I disable the LUT, see, this is what the Cineon gamma looks like. So it's a flat gamma. But the problem now is that you can't dial back the LUT. Some of you might find these LUTs, I really have to make a pause there. These LUTs, some of you might find them too strong. What if you want to dial it back to, let's say, 50%? Well, you can't, because normally you can go to the key tab here and then lower the gain, and it will make the look less strong. But the problem here is that if you lower the gain now, you'll just revert the image back to Cineon film log. And, well, you can see it here. You're just reducing the contrast and the saturation, basically. You're not dialing back the LUT. So let me show you a variation now that'll allow you to dial back the LUT, make it look less strong. But first, I want to talk about Motion VFX, the sponsor of this video. Motion VFX offers insanely high quality plugins for DaVinci Resolve 18, and there's something for everyone. The creator toolboxes like MTuber 3 or MKBHD contain everything you need if you're running a YouTube channel. But they also offer a bunch of cool LUTs, transitions, and of course titles. One of my favorite plugins is MTitle Film, which contains titles based on movies. I've used a really cool title from this pack for my Apple commercial. I'll link the tutorial on how I did that in the description. But I also love MTitle Hype. It has a more modern, urban look. And the new MTitle Restyle plugin looks awesome, and it's discounted for just a few more days. If you want to check it out, the link is in the description. So thank you Motion VFX for sponsoring this video. And now back to DaVinci Resolve. So here's a better way to apply that Cineon film log conversion so that you can dial back the LUT. Instead of setting the output gamma in the color space transform to Cineon film log, I'm gonna set it back to use timeline. So we're back to Rec 709 now. The LUT looks horrible, way too dark. But what I'm gonna do now is add a new node here in between the color space transform and the LUT. And this is gonna be a second color space transform node. So drop it on there. And all I'm gonna do here is set the output gamma to Cineon film log. And that's it. And now the LUT looks great again. And if you want to dial back the LUT, all you have to do is select the Cineon film log node and the LUT node, right click and create compound node. And now when we go to the key tab, the gain will work properly. And if we go all the way to zero, see, we're just getting Rec 709 and not a flat Cineon film log look. I found this technique on Darren Mostyn's channel, by the way. I'll link his channel in the description. If you want to do some serious hardcore color grading, definitely check out his channel. Okay, and then finally, what if you're not working with log footage? Well, it's simple really. It probably means that you're working with Rec 709 footage. So footage shot with a standard picture profile on your camera, which most cameras have. So your footage already looks good, it has contrast and saturation, but now you want to color grade it a little bit. Well, then the difference now is that you're not gonna need that color space transform node to transform the log footage to Rec 709 footage, because it already is Rec 709 footage. So, this is Rec 709 footage, and what you have to do is add a color space transform node. So add a node, then drop a color space transform onto that node and set the output color gamma to Cineon film log. And then add another node, and this is the node on which you'll apply one of DaVinci Resolve's built-in Rec 709 film look LUTs. And that's it. And if you want to make some small adjustments, again, you can do that before the color space transform. Make as many nodes as you want here and adjust the white balance, contrast, exposure, skin tones, whatever. And of course, you can also use the same technique that I showed you before to dial back the look, the LUT. And that's it. Fast, easy, and free. What more do you want? You'll never have to buy LUTs again. I mean, except for Motion VFX LUTs and my LUTs, of course. Keep buying my LUTs because I need money for food and beer. Thank you so much. See you in the next one.